The future of the Star Wars franchise seems to be quite expansive, not just their books, comics, novels, and video games, but also their live-action TV series and their animated TV shows, and let's not forget about their new Star Wars trilogy in the works over at Lucasfilm. This is Mike Zero. Make sure to subscribe if you're new to the channel for future Star Wars content. Now, the thing about Disney Star Wars is that as of this moment right now, they are building this new universe. Basically, what they are doing is they have George Lucas, Dave Filoni, and Jon Favreau essentially giving us a brand new EU that is said to be far more expansive than the old one that we got back in the 90s and the 2000s. And a lot of this is going to stem from the live-action TV shows on Disney Plus, such as The Mandalorian Season 2 and Season 3, the Ahsoka Tano TV series, they got a Mace Windu TV show in the early development phase, and even a Jedi Purge TV series, and so on and so forth. That's going to be the big part. The other part is their books, their novels, and stuff around those lines for the fans that love to read material. I myself included. Now, when we look at everything related to Disney Star Wars, we have both Bob Iger and Bob Chapek really working at their absolute best in order to really fix aspects of Star Wars and to also improve the MCU. That's another task that they're trying to complete as we speak right now, as we go throughout this crisis that's happening around the world. So the thing about everything related to Disney Plus and this new universe, the thing that really does excite me the most is, of course, the major changes that will be applied to the character of Luke Skywalker in this new universe. It's going to make us view him in a different way when we go ahead and watch the movies and everything that happens after the films in the original trilogy. So, with that being said, now that both Disney and Lucasfilm are finished with The Rise of Skywalker, they are focused on their new Star Wars trilogy of films, as well as their new Star Wars universe. Now, currently, both Bob Iger and Bob Chapek are hard at work on developing their new Star Wars universe, as well as focusing on the Disney Plus platform and the upcoming Star Wars films. However, their plan for the new universe is to provide many retcons for many of the main characters, such as Luke Skywalker in this new expanded universe for the Star Wars community. Now, it's explained that one of the major retcons that creator George Lucas, Dave Filoni, and Jon Favreau will take control of is the introduction of Luke Skywalker's wife and a story about the tragedy of Luke Skywalker's wife in the new expanded universe that will mainly begin sometime in 2021. It's noted that they are currently in the middle of designing Luke Skywalker's wife for a new era that takes place some years after the events of Return of the Jedi, right around the time period of the Mandalorian TV series. Now, it's explained that Luke's wife is said to be heavily inspired from Mara Jade from Star Wars Legends, however, is said to go under a brand new name to change things up in order to not confuse the fans. Currently, the character of Luke's wife goes under the simple name of Madeline Sage. It's explained that Madeline Sage is going to have a close resemblance to Mara Jade in the new expanded universe for Star Wars as Luke Skywalker's wife, and that they are exploring options to tell a story of how Luke and Madeline met some years after the events of Return of the Jedi. Now, Lucasfilm is set to make Madeline Sage a collector of Jedi lore that explores the galaxy and eventually runs into Luke Skywalker, and eventually becomes a part of his new Jedi Order with his Jedi students. Lucasfilm is going to explain the origin of how Luke built his Jedi training temple on that unknown world and how it will connect to Madeline Sage in the new universe for Star Wars fans to enjoy. Luke's backstory, of course, and his road to becoming a Jedi Master. Now, it's explained that Lucasfilm is desperate to repair the damage done to Luke after what Rian Johnson as a director did to the beloved character in The Last Jedi, and that Disney overall wants to gain the lost fans of those who had issues with the sequel trilogy movies. So, the thing about this that's really interesting is that they're doing the exact same thing that they are doing with Cade Skywalker. So, Cade Skywalker, in case you guys did not know, is going to become a part of the new canon under Disney, except he too will also be getting a new name. It's going to be Zane Skywalker, where he's going to have a similar appearance to that of Cade. Now, we went over this before already in the past, but this, however, is very interesting, and I kind of really do like the name. It sounds Star Wars-y, at least in my opinion. You go from Mara Jade to Madeline Sage. It, in a real strange way, it sounds similar. I don't know if that was done intentionally, but it does sound similar. You have Mara Jade to Madeline Sage. Now, Madeline Sage is going to essentially be this Jedi collector of Jedi lore, whatever have you. And that's going to be the backbone of how she meets Luke, because we also know that Luke and Lor San Tekka, by the way, is the old guy that was portrayed by Max von Sydow in the very beginning of The Force Awakens that was killed off on Jakku. He was actually a very close friend to Luke and pretty much traveled across the entire galaxy to collect and hide Jedi lore from the remnants of the Empire all the way up until the Force, to the First Order. So this character, Madeline Sage, like I say, I'm very excited to see how close of a resemblance we're gonna get to Mara Jade, and as far as personality, you know, how it's gonna be, and everything related to this new EU, I think it really is off to a great start. So with that being said, guys, you know, drop a comment below. Let me know about all of this in the comments. And if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.
Again.